Hey everybody, guess what? Tour de Fleece is coming. And if you're like, what is Tour de Fleece? Tour de Fleece, see, I actually forget that the Tour de France is a, I'm like, oh yeah, people on bicycles? The Tour de Fleece is when all the crazy spinners decide that we're gonna spin and set challenges while the Tour de France is going on. So while they're spinning on their bicycles, we're spinning on our spinning wheels. That's the idea with Tour de Fleece. And I'm going to try to make this video not long and rambly. So, you know, if you want the long backstory on that, come jump in our Facebook group and someone will explain that to you, or I've already made some posts. But what you need to know as a yarn lover is, one, if you already are a spinner, whether a drop spindle spinner or a spinning wheel spinner, or you have one your grandma gave you and you haven't used it yet and you're totally confused, Tour de Fleece is a really good time, at least in Crafty Housewife Yarns, to jump on board with spinning. Because we gear a lot of our stuff towards education. So the general idea is it's going to run, and I am bad with getting my numbers flip-flopped, but unless I read it wrong, June 26th through July 19th is Tour de Fleece. So it's roughly 3 weeks. So, you know, it's not something that like, oh my God, if you miss the first day, like, you know, the end of the world, like, at least with us, you can kind of jump in and jump out. But Sankovit is a big challenge. So what we do is it is typically hosted on Ravelry. And I think we will officially be signed up as a wild card team. But just being totally honest with us, most of the magic happens in the Handspun Yarn Love Facebook group, which is linked above or below or next to me or somewhere on this page. So please go click over to our Facebook group and join, because that is where just historically most of our posting and sharing and education and all that happens. So definitely make sure you're in the Facebook group. And what we're going to do is everybody kind of sets your own individual goal for the time. So if you're brand new, your goal could be, I'm going to learn to spin at all. Like, I'm going to spin one yarn that looks sort of like yarn that I can keep and as a keepsake or, you know, decorative table item. So that could be your goal. Or if you're a seasoned spinner, you could be like, I'm going to master fractal spinning, or, you know, something much more whatever it is that, you know, you've been meaning to do and you haven't done, or you want to like, I'm going to get, you know, set your own goal. So everybody's going to set their own goal. And we also last year encouraged everybody to kind of have maybe, because we like to talk a lot about like the meditative parts of spinning. And so with spinning or knitting, I know if like the same idea with like a prayer shawl, where when you're knitting a prayer shawl that you would be, you know, I think the idea is that you are praying while you're knitting it, and then it's full of all those good vibes and goes to the person. So we also last year kind of encouraged everybody to maybe have something positive that you were wanting to focus on, either like personally or in your community or whatever, of like a positive focus while you were spinning for, you know, kind of more of the meditative, you know, self-help aspect of spinning and crafting that way. Or even if it's just like relaxation. That's how I got into spinning, was a difficult pregnancy and being up late at night. So I mean, it doesn't have to be anything deep and you don't even have to do that. But we do always encourage people with our team to have something kind of positive to, you know, think on while you are doing all of the spinning. So you need to set a goal. That's your, so first thing, go join the group. Second thing, pick out whatever your goal is going to be. And then we will also be doing education that you don't necessarily have to go with. We do also do prizes. So prizes are a thing. We usually do a prize for most yardage on spinning wheel, most yardage on drop spindle, because it'd be unfair to make those two compete. Most ounceage on both spinning wheel and drop spindle, I think. So yeah, most weight, most yardage, and then there's a drop spindle division and a spinning wheel division for both of those. I think we usually, I don't know, we get pretty excited. There's usually like a wild card. I think we usually have like most improved beginner. So I don't know, we do lots of prizes. So you got to post, make your, you know, so you go on, decide what your goal is. You post like, hey, I'm Erin and I'm going to learn to, you know, my goal is most yardage on the drop spindle. And, you know, I mean, my goal is to learn to drop spin and, you know, be the best improved newbie. So, you know, whatever your goal is, you go post that in the group, and then everybody starts on the same day, on the 26th, and that's the goal, is for everybody to start. And the idea is that you're supposed to spend a little bit every day that the Tour de France is happening. So that's why it's the Tour de Fleece. So a little bit every day, and practice makes perfect. And if you also, we will be doing staff videos on just kind of some basic stuff on really geared towards new people, but we'll probably get some people that have specialties to pop on and maybe do some videos on that. So you do not have to follow along with what we're doing, but we definitely will have like maybe something on drafting, like even spinning. That's why I said if you are new to spinning or just curious, like it's worth hanging out to get the free education on that. And if you don't have a drop spindle, but you're like, hey, I want to participate, you can make your own drop spindle. So this is our, from the blog Brittany wrote, and isn't it pretty? This is from the blog that Brittany wrote for us. And then we actually have, if you want a video demonstrating how to make this, I have a little tiny course on our website that comes with like a step-by-step video on this. But there's also a free blog on our website on how to make this. So depending on how much hand-holding you feel that you need, if you don't have anything, you can make yourself one of these. And we do have fiber that I need to send an email. Because I got the fiber for our Tour de Fleece braids. They're up. They're up on the website. And I made the mistake of thinking that, you know, nobody's really going to find them until I send out that email, right? And people are already finding them and they're getting bought. So that is not a bad thing, clearly. It just means that I need to quit going to kids' birthday parties and write more emails, I guess. So if you need some fiber, we do have the Tour de Fleece braids as of yesterday squeaked onto the website, kind of under the radar, but people have already found them. So they are selling. Just like the sea glass mini braid sets that sold out like in an hour. So those are also gone. And I have ordered more of those to be restocked. So those, if you are very sad that you missed the sea glass mini bats, mini braids, we're getting more of those in, but it will be a limited run of the more of them. So I will send out an email on that. But we do have some mini braids that are very patriotic that I'm excited about. I think I'm gonna spend one of those. That'd be good for like a color challenge. So anyhow, I'm not gonna ramble. I promised I wasn't gonna ramble. So comment below if you are a spinner and want to participate. If you are just a yarn lover and you're like, this could be fun, these people seem crazy, and you need like some guidance on like, hey, click this link, here's the blog, so you have any questions, because you can totally, you get yourself one of these, and you don't have to buy, oh yeah, that is important, you don't have to have fiber from us, that you don't, you can totally compete and hang out and do all the things, and you do not have to have all your fiber from us, because we usually have way more people participate then we have fiber that we could sell. And so we're just doing this for fun and for community, but of course, you know, I mean, we always make fiber because that's what we do all the time. So there will be fiber. Heidi has bats, lots of stuff to come. Go join the Facebook group and comment below this video if you have any like, yay, I'm a spinner, I'm gonna join, hey, I need to learn more about a drop spindle, that sort of thing, and somebody will get you going in the right direction. So I think that's it. I promise not to ramble. So y'all have a great day, and off to go finish some yarn myself.